The year is 2025, and I know that many people out there are total PC enthusiasts who would never think in a million years about turning to the dark side, the world of Macs. But in today's market, if you're not a hardcore gamer, do you really need to have a PC, or would a Mac actually work better for you? I can hear the people throwing cans at me and screeching. But anyways, before somebody comes and fucks me up, let's jump into the video. Did you just buy a brand new computer or upgrade your old computer with so many parts it's now asking for a new Windows key and you don't have one? Well, check this out. VIP Your CD Key has you covered, and you don't have to pay Bill Gates that $199 price tag at all. You can get it right now for under $25, and it's easier than ever to do. All you do is you go over to the website. On their website, you create an account. After that, you go and find your software. You put your software in the cart, enter the code TOT20. It will give you a wonderful 25% discount. You go to the checkout. After you do the checkout, check your email a couple of minutes later. You will have the code in there. Put it in your computer and activate your computer. It's that simple. And check it out. All of these codes are guaranteed for life. So save yourself some money and check out the links below. Okay, now that the ad's out of the way, if you like the video, please like the video because it helps the video. There you go. And if you like what you see in the channel, hey, hit that sub button. We'd love to see you back here once again. So check this out. Like I said in the beginning, I know that most of my users out there are hardcore PC gamers, and the thought of even switching to a Mac in any way, shape, or form makes them just think that they're being a complete traitor to the PC kind. And I'm going to be honest with you. In the beginning, when this all started off, you could say that I was almost on a PC cheerleading squad. I was cheering that stuff on, and I wanted a big part of it. But honestly, the very, like, I would say mid-time between me quitting being into computers and getting back into them, a friend of mine, Brian Downing, the guy who has done the artwork that's in my house and stuff, he had a Mac, and he was an artist, and I played little silly games on that thing, you know, and then had a girl I knew, and I started playing Dig Dug. Totally different thing, but the bottom line is I used to be totally into PCs, totally into PC gaming, would never even consider to even have a Mac whatsoever. And really, the only reason that I ever started thinking about having a Mac is when I started hanging out with Jonathan from TLD, he is like my adopted stepson. Like, we call each other father and son. We started recording music together, and we tried doing it on a PC. Honestly, I spent, at least $15,000 going through various types of equipment, trying to get something that just sounded really, really good, that we could use at home, and that was simple enough for everybody to do. And we just ended up giving up, and I ended up getting my first Mac. And I fought it at first. But once I started using that Mac, slowly but surely, it became my computer of choice. And what's crazy is the Macs that are around these days have pretty much knocked out all of the things that would disillusion anybody from back in my day. Like, the things that I was disillusioned about in the very beginning, like super duper high prices, you couldn't even really get into one without selling a kidney, that's all changed, because you can get into a Mac Mini for dirt cheap. I've seen these things on eBay for as low as like $379. And if you get an M1, even if it's the first generation, this thing will play games. It will do everything that you want to do. It's quiet, so it can be used in a music studio without having blowing fans and whirring noises and hard drive noises and all of these other things. So when you're considering things these days, having a PC may not really be what you need anymore. It really might not be. A lot of my friends, they'll fight me about switching over to the Mac ecosystem. But if they're not being hardcore gamers anymore, they still play games, but they're not hardcore like they used to be. You can play games. The new Mac Minis, any of the new iMacs, any of the new laptops they have coming out are all so very, very powerful with these new M3 processors. They just keep getting bigger and better and better as time goes along. And yes, you can use a converter and you can play all kinds of games. They integrate great with your iPhone. You can switch files, pictures, do all kinds of crazy things. And Jonathan eventually talked me into pretty much giving up my PC other than for gaming. And as I started getting older, and you guys know I went blind for a while, and I started having vision impairment a long time before that, but being a guy, I just shined that shut on. I was like, oh, I'll be okay. But I really couldn't game anymore, especially the first person shooter stuff. I couldn't really zoom in and stuff and lock into people, and I would just get shot and get killed all the time. But lately, I've been really starting to crave to get into gaming again. And I found out that through my Mac Mini, I can play a lot of games that I never could play before through their translator and through Steam. So unless you're trying to play the latest first-person shooter, there are a lot of top-down games, the latest Diablo. There are things, there are just so many things that you can do now on a Mac that you could never, ever do before. The system's gotten so powerful that, honestly, I think that if they just decided tomorrow that they were going to dedicate and change all of their stuff to gaming, they could do it. It would probably take a bigger amount of hardware space because we all see how these giant NVIDIA video cards are these days. They're like a tank this big. They take an external power supply. You've actually got to have a link up to a satellite and an alien who's sending you power just to keep the damn thing running. So it's gotten crazy. But if you just want to game and have some fun, you can do it. And plus, with cloud gaming isn't that bad. A lot of people complain, oh, cloud gaming, yeah. It's honestly not that bad. It really isn't. Maybe there might be some sacrifice with some graphics, but if you have a pretty decent internet connection, which most people do these days, I have found that playing the games online through a cloud and all that can actually be quite fun. So it depends on your headspace. One thing that I just really like about the whole Macverse is, like I said, a lot of you guys out there, you have iPhones. Don't even deny it. You may be a PC enthusiast, but you've got an iPhone. Well, if you get any type of Mac, your iPhone will become an extension of your computer and vice versa. Telephone numbers, information, pictures, it all just goes together and you can game. And like I said, you can get these new Mac Minis and some of the older iMacs for an unbelievably low price right now. You get something that's in the M2, M3 range, you might be paying like $700 or $800. But think about it. PCs for a decent gaming machine are a lot of money. They take up a lot of space. And if you're somebody who's doing any type of music and you need something that's silent, the Mac Mini is just the absolute shit. It's totally, utterly silent. It's like this big, and it's been running my studio for years now. All of the music that you've heard, even though I have all this outlandish equipment all around here and all down in our recording studio in the basement, still just using a little tiny Mac Mini to power it all and it's working out amazing. Plus, playing games. It plays games. I'm not really into all the crazy first-person shooters, even though I got my vision back. I'm just not really like that. I like more like Command and Conquer, tower stuff like that, where you're just defending the stuff, and games that use your mind. I even like Scrabble and chess. So for me, these days, unless I need a computer that's going to be totally dedicated to doing hardcore first-person shooters that require the ultimate graphics card for these crazy, insane visuals that are in it, and I'm just going to say this right now, I don't think that a lot of these first-person shooters have changed all that much from the original fucking Doom. It's the same game over and over again with a different skin, with maybe a different bit of a storyline. Some of them, yes, have been way better than others, but let's just face it. They're the same thing repetitively over and over and over again. Once you find really a great first-person shooter you like, you're probably only going to have two or three that you actually play that you like out of all the Zackens of them that are out there. I think I just made a new word. Zackens. Zackens means too damn many to even count. So at the end of the day these days, before you just go, oh, to game, I have to have a PC. No, you don't. Macs these days will actually play games. And like I said, unless you're just a hardcore person who plays 3D first-person shooters, you don't need that big, expensive PC tower anymore. They're big, they're usually kind of loud, and like I said, if you do music and you need something silent, the Mac Mini is just the shit. I'm Elric. I love to hear your comments down below. If you have something to say that's negative, I don't mind. Just don't be rude about it. There's no reason to be rude in anybody's video whatsoever, even if you disagree with something. You can just say you disagree, and you can explain why. That's why I make these videos. I'm Elric Farez. You guys have been watching Tech of Tomorrow. We'll see you guys back on here for more videos coming up this month in June. Peace!